Hello, I'm Mike. Some Power BI users asked if we have the Power BI combined no-level security and object-level security for end user to access reports and dashboard. For example, in an organization, some users can only see their own sales but not cost and profit, and other users can see their own sales, cost and profit. For the requirement, I tried Power BI low-level security feature with external tool Tabular editor RLS for a combined role. For example, in screen, I have the Power BI RLS sample file for organizational hierarchy in my previous video. In the file by Tabular editor RLS, I have added the column level security to the role RLS hierarchy user group regarding the column cost and profit. My testing shows a message as unable to view as the selected rows. The explained reason in detail is displayed in the message and also mentioned as Microsoft site stated that low-level security and object-level security cannot be combined from the different role. For reference, I attached the Microsoft site URL link in video description. After checking and reading related materials, especially the book Microsoft Power BI Cookbook wrote by Greg and Blatt, you may refer to the reference URL link in video description. I found a columns level security creation method and extended the method to combine low-level security and column level security by using Power BI low-level security feature with a modeling design. In my Power BI file, I have a 3 layers organization as example. First layer has 4 sales representatives. They are DD, EE, F, and GG. Second and third layers are manager layers. They are AA, BB, and CC. I have created 2 roles in this file. One is RLS hierarchy user group, in which members can view their own organizational sales, cost, and profit. All managers are in this user group. Another role is combined RLS and CLS hierarchy user group, in which members can only view their own sales info, but not cost and profit. All sales representatives are in this user group. I have created different bar, column, and table charts in 3 report pages. Especially in the table chart, we can see price, sales, cost, and profit values in corresponding columns. Let's place manager bbemailart.test.com in the role of the RLS hierarchy user group. By the view of manager BB, he can see all info of his team, includes info of himself. Let's place sales representative ddemailart.test.com in the role of the RLS and CLS hierarchy user group. By the view of the DD, he is able to see only sales values but not cost and profit. Compared to Tabular editor RLS, by this method, sales representative DD knows that cost and profit values are existing in the data model but not visible to him. In some situations, this kind of view visibility could be useful features in an organization. In the rest of the video, I shall demonstrate the steps on how to create a combined RLS and CLS role for organizational hierarchy. The step 1 is design the column level security while data modeling by splitting the sales table original into sales table and cost table, in which the cost table includes profit values. In screen, the example Power BI file has the same data modeling design and low-level security setup as my previous video, RLS for organizational hierarchy. You may find the video from my channel. It has 1 dimension table, employee hierarchy table, 1 factor table, sales table original, and 1 measure table, which hosts all created measures from this data model. In data view, choose the sales table original. Right-click the Edit Query. In Query Editor, on top ribbon, choose a column tab, choose and click the drop-down list of index column, then choose from 1. An index column is added in the end of the table. On the left side, right-click the sales table original. Disable the enable load. Please continue to close the warning message. On top ribbon, ensure home tab is chosen. Then in drop-down list of the new source, choose blank query. Name the query as a sales table. Right-click on it and choose the advanced editor. In editor, enter hash sign for the formula after source. Then choose sales table original from the list table. Click done. In sales table, remove all columns related to cost and profit. Again, in the drop-down list of new source, choose blank query. Name the query as a cost table. Repeat the previous same steps to query sales table original. In the cost table, keep only the columns of index, cost, and profit. Control select both sales table and cost table. Right-click on them. In the pop-up dialog list, choose Move to Group. Click New Group. Name the group as a fact. Then in the left side, we see new fact query group created and the two new created tables are moved into the query group. Click Close and apply the changes on query editing. Move to Model View. We see that a new data model is set up, and which includes the sales and cost tables plus existing employee hierarchy table and the measure table. And the sales table original is unloaded and invisible in the model view. The suggest relationships among these tables are rebuilt automatically. To enable the later CLS working for the suggest relationship between sales table and cost table, we need to change the one-to-one bi-direction relationships to one-to-many single direction. One is at the sales table side, and many is at the cost table side. This single cross-field direction is an important setup that allows us to apply RLS DAX function through the mapped index to show values of the sales table and at the same time hide all column value of cost table. And this phase, the data model has been modified. We need to check and rebuild all measures which have been created based on the old data model for the visualizations in all report pages. Step 2 is create RLS and CLS combined row. After rebuilding all related measures, move to the report view. On top ribbon, choose Modeling tab, click Manage Rows, create new row and name it as RLS and CLS Hierarchy User Group. On the table list, choose Cost Table. In table, DAX field expression, enter the is blanket, open bracket, place index column in, close bracket, which tells if the index column value is blank, then the DAX field expression returns true, otherwise false, which means that if returned value is false, this is our expected value. The values of the cost table will not be shown in visualization. Finally, it enables column level security control. To the new row, RLS and CLS Hierarchy User Group, we still need to keep the RLS for organizational hierarchy rule as the existing RLS hierarchy user group. Copy the DAX field expression from RLS hierarchy user group and paste it to the employee hierarchy table DAX field expression field under the new rule of RLS and CLS hierarchy user group. Save. The RLS combined CLS rule is ready for testing. Step 3 is a test and publish it to Power BI service side to enable the security setting and dataset level and workspace access level. On top ribbon, under Modeling tab, choose View as, tick on the RLS hierarchy user group and other user. Enter the manager BB email at test.com into the empty box of other user. Press OK. Then in table chart by the view of the manager BB, we see values of the sales, cost, and profit of his team. Check other page visualizations. We see that only his team's value are visible. Stop the view of the manager BB. Tick on RLS and CLS hierarchy user group and other user. Enter sales representative DD email at test.com into the empty box. Press OK. Then in table chart by the view of DD, we see only his sales related values are visible. Cost and profit columns are visible but with empty values. Check other page visualization, only his sales related info are visible. Now it is time to publish report to enable the combined RLS and CLS for end user and service side. We need to assign the list employee into the corresponding two security roles and dataset security setting, and also make sure those employees are viewer user group category. For detailed setting, please refer to my previous video, RLS for Organizational Hierarchy. Please let me know your comments or if you have other alternative solutions for combined RLS and OLS setting. If you like to watch more videos from my channel, please press subscribe button in below. Thanks for your watching and see you in next video.